4. Rocks, soils and minerals. Soils. Hi children. Rock is a naturally occurring soil aggregate of one or more minerals. Rocks have been used by mankind throughout history. From the Stone Age, rocks have been used for tools. The minerals and metals found in rocks have been essential to human civilization. Soil is the mixture of minerals, organic matter, gases, liquids, and organisms. It is a natural body that supports as a medium for plant growth. It is a means of water storage, supply, and purification, and also it is a modifier of the atmosphere of Earth. A mineral is a naturally occurring substance that is solid and inorganic, and also it is different from a rock, which can be an aggregate of minerals or non-minerals. In this lesson, you will learn about the rocks, soils, and minerals.
Unit 4. Rocks, soils, and minerals. Soils. Our Earth surface is made up of rocks, water, and soil. Soil is very important for the growth of plants. Plants absorb water and mineral salts from the soil through the roots. Soil gives support to the plant.
Good soil produces healthy plants. Healthy plants give us good vegetables and fruits for good health.
Formation of soil. In the beginning, there was no life on the earth. It is covered with different kinds of rocks. By the action of sun, the wind, and the rain, these rocks break into smaller pieces. The sun heats the rock and causes cracks in it. Rainwater enters into these cracks. In winter, water freezes. This continued for many years. The heating and cooling breaks down rocks into smaller pieces. These pieces of rocks are carried to other places by running water, moving ice, and strong winds. In this way, soil was formed. Constituents of soil. Soils of different places on the earth differ from one another. Most of the soil contains coarse particles of gravel, small pieces of stones, sand particles, clay particles, humus, moisture, and air. Let us prove by doing some experiments. Activity 1. Take a beaker filled with water. Add half full of garden soil and shake well and leave it undisturbed for some time. Look at the beaker carefully. Now answer the questions given below. Is something floating on the surface of beaker? Which makes the water muddy? Where are the big particles? Humus, clay, sand, gravel. Activity 2. Take a lump of soil in a beaker filled with water. We shall see air bubbles coming up. This shows the air is trapped in the soil. Activity 3. Take some soil in a small vessel. Cover it with a lid and heat it slowly. Open the lid. What do you see? Tiny droplets of water. This shows that it has moisture.
The dead plants and animals which have decayed in the soil form humus. Humus is dark brown or black in color.
Kinds of soils. Soils are of different kinds. Four kinds of soils are the most common. 1. Gravel. It is made up of large rock particles called gravel. They do not hold any water between them. They hold a lot of air. 2. Sand. It is formed by the grains of rocks smaller than gravel. The soil on the sea beaches and river banks is mainly made up of sand. Deserts are also mainly sandy. When water is poured on sand, it quickly sinks to the bottom. This shows sandy soil doesn't hold water. Clay is very sticky in nature. It is made up of very fine grains which stick together. It can hold a lot of water but very little air. Clay is used for making toys, pots, bricks and other articles. 4. Loam. It contains both sand and clay in equal amounts. It can hold both enough air and enough water for the growth of plants. If we add some humus to this, it becomes the best garden soil for the best growth of plants. Activity. Form into four pairs and do the following experiments. First, pour water in each flower pot. Observe which soil will hold more water. Write the name of the soil. Layers of soil. Soil has different layers. It is a mixture of sand, clay, and humus. Most of the soils have three layers. Activity. Go to the school garden and observe the top layer of the soil. Dig up and pick up some soil in your hand and peel the grains. Top soil. The layer of the soil which is loose and contains roots of plants and grass is called topsoil. Plants grow mostly in this soil. Subsoil. The soil below the top layer consists of closely packed soil with some pieces of rocks. This layer is harder than topsoil. This is called subsoil. Bedrock. If the soil is dug further, we get a layer of large rocks. This is called bedrock. Nothing can pass through the solid rock. Soil and crops. Soils in different places are different in nature. Different types of crops grow in different kinds of soils. Some crops grow on sandy soil, some on clay soil, while others grow on loamy soil. To grow a better crop, the soil should contain enough water, air, and minerals. The soil should also have enough humus. Minerals can be supplied to the soil by adding natural manures and fertilizers. Farmers add these to make the soil fertile. Let's revise the important points. 1. Soil is formed by the breaking up of rocks. 2. By the action of the sun, the wind, and the rain, rocks break into smaller pieces. 3. Dead animals and plants make humus. 4. Gravel, sand, clay, and loam are 4 kinds of soils. 5. Loam is the best soil for the plant growth. 6. Soil gives support, water, and mineral salts to the plants. 7. Farmers and manures and fertilizers to make the soil fertile. Do these. 1. Answer the